Yo, welcome to Internet Music Marketing. Right now I'm going to teach you how Drake's market strategy for releasing Scorpion was genius and how you could implement it yourself. Well, this is pretty easy. It was genius because of the length of the tracks. It was basically in that. And also how he used his audience and distributed its attention between the tracks. So let's start with this. You can get the point by now if you have listened to the album. If you haven't listened to the album, it's an okay album, but you know, it's just my opinion. I'm going to leave my best, the best line in the whole album after the video ends, so you can hear it. That's just my opinion. I don't want you to get mad, you know. What's the problem with that, man? Right now, what I'm trying to do is going to explain you why Drake's strategy was genius. So let's start. The normal length of an album is about 12 tracks to 14 tracks to 18, you know, and that's long album, you know. The thing is, the platform of music distribution, distribution have shifted. So right now we have, instead of having iTunes where people bought their individual music, they have Spotify where they have it for free. Of course, the price we pay is by looking at ads, and that's how they make money and sort of that. So that was genius. That's why the market is centered more in singles. That's what I'm trying to say. Right now it's not like who sells the most albums. It's mostly who sells the most singles. That's where the money is right now. So you want to make money, release a lot of singles inside an album. That's one of the suggestions. Also, you can see a lot of that in also in the Migos album, and because Migos albums also have like 20 plus tracks. That's a lot. That's insane. So they took advantage of the system, and some of the tracks were hits inside there, so people listen to the whole album. The same that about here, but right now I'm trying to center in how he took advantage of his audience. I'm not saying he took advantage of his audience in a bad way. I'm just saying like how that was so genius right now. The thing he did is that Drake for the last 3 years have shifted. He was before a rapper more like with hard beats and everything, like you could dance, you know? But right now he's more like a singing guy, R&B guy. Oh, I am Drake and I sing so beautiful. It's like that. It's my very bad impression of new Drake. But before that, he was more like a rapper and hard and everything. Like me. So, yeah. So, what I'm trying to tell is that before 2015, Drake's audience was more male. And after 2015, because women like all that singing and, you know, like me, I like to sing, la, la, la. You know, women like that. So the Drake's audience shifted, and now is more woman-centered. But with doing that, he left his male audience, like, you know, like that. So what happened is, like, you know, the male audience like Super from Drake. And the Drake's from 3 years is rising numbers of women seeing his videos, women listening to his music, which is great. But I mean, there's also not the 50% of the other people of the countries are male also. So he needs to try to market to that. So what he did is to recover his male fan base, he made side A with 12 tracks of more male oriented tracks with beats that you can, you know, bang your head, like, you know. And he did this A side B of the album, which is mostly female oriented tracks, you know, the tracks that are singing and everything. So with that, with those two, side A, side B, he marketed for male and for female. So he has his both audience pleased. So I say, the customer perspective is like, I'm a male, but I want to. I like these 12 tracks from Drake, which are from side A. So say, but the other side B, I don't like it. But this because they have it right there, they're going to buy the album anyways. And women, because they like Drake and they have another side B, it is going to do the same. What I'm trying to tell you is that Drake used his audience very intelligently. So he provided value to the male and to the female. So that's how he is now making numbers. He's making like first day he makes like 100 million streams in just Apple Music, which is amazing. So we have to see if what is strategy is very effective. I think it's going to destroy Post Malone's numbers and bring new records into the game because the strategy is great. It's like a loophole, man. So thank you for watching this video. Hope you got some type of value and hope you can use it in your music marketing strategy. Kisses and have a nice right now or day. Have a nice day.